In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome, my dear brother and sister, to this evening message, the Good Night message, this Tuesday. And before we take up the reading, we have wronged God in one way or another. Let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's pardon, mercy and strength. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us have a reading. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter, chapter 5, from verse 8 to 9. Be sober and vigilant. Your opponent, the devil, is prowling around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in faith. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Welcome, my dear brother and sister, to this evening reflection before we take our rest. What St. Peter is telling us, we ought to be sober, we ought to be vigilant. And what does St. Peter want to tell us? That as we take our rest, as I've always said, we've come through so much today. Probably there were so many disappointments, there were also appointments, there are also times that you are not happy. So we are being told to be vigilant so that we don't give room for the devil. And this devil comes through the regrets. This devil comes through the revenge. This devil comes through the hate that we have with other people. So we are told to be vigilant so that such things should not happen in our lives. Because the moment we give room for the devil, then that becomes the root cause of other sins that come in our lives. So today what St. Peter is telling us, that as you take rest, my dear people of God, then be sure you go to sleep when you don't have hate in you, don't have that feeling, anger in you, and all that. So that if you are able to do away with that, then you're going to sleep peacefully. Other than that, you're going to sin more, because maybe the things even of wanting to finish someone may come to your mind. Those are the things that St. Peter is talking about, that let us not give room for the devil when such things are bound to happen in our lives. Today again you see what St. Peter is saying, that the devil is going round like a roaring lion, just looking for someone to finish. You know, that is what happens. At times, somebody might have told you something that was not happy, that made you not happy. Maybe someone told you something that made you got sad. My dear people of God, let that not make you give room for the devil. You need to sleep in peace. You need to sleep when you are relaxed. You need to sleep when your thoughts are all focused on God, and even that rest, so that when you wake up tomorrow to take up the task of tomorrow, you are okay. People of God, let me encourage you, my dear brother. Let me encourage you, my dear sister. What you will do tomorrow, God willing, will not be measured by what you experience today. Probably you must have experienced a bad day today. I want to assure you, people of God, that tomorrow will be a new day. Tomorrow will have new energy. Tomorrow will overcome. Tomorrow will be conquerors. Let us pray, people of God, that we may not give room for the devil, and make sure and know that what we need in our lives is to give gratitude to God and not focus on what today was, but let us focus on what God has for us in store tomorrow. Remember, it doesn't matter where you've come from. It doesn't matter how your Tuesday was. But let us commit ourselves to God, and we know tomorrow, Wednesday, will be a better day for us. Amen. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. You have redeemed us, Lord God of truth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake we may keep watch with Christ, and asleep rest in his peace. At last, all-powerful Master, you give leave to your servant to go in peace according to your promise. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared for all nations, the light to enlighten the Gentiles and give glory to Israel, your people. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake you may keep watch with Christ, and asleep rest in his peace. Let us pray. Lord, fill this night with your radiance. May we sleep in peace and rise with joy to welcome the light of a new day in your name. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you so much, my dear brother and sister. I've been your priest, Father Mika Kibet Kemboi. Have a blessed night.